fringe of the culture of Bharat. I always, wherever I go into any country, I first say namaskar, and in their language, whatever is appropriate. Sri Venkatesh, Sri Radhagaru, and friends. A fear is haunting the globe. Just as a specter was haunting the globe, that was a communist phrase, the specter of communism in the mid 19th century. Today, what is haunting the world is America's credibility, its liquidity, its ability to discharge all the obligations that it owes to the world. The dollar has become, after the Second World War, the global currency, and after the World Trade Organization, etc., it is America which is driving the global financial markets. 25% of the world's gross wealth is America's share. $9.5 trillion, the foreign exchange that are held by all the countries in the world is $9.5 trillion, and all that is denoted in the American dollars. Two-thirds of whatever dollars are being printed in the United States are held by people outside the United States. Every day, $4 trillion worth of foreign exchange, forex markets, $4 trillion are transacted. Of that, 42% is denoted in US currency. With these massive figures, when Standard & Poor's has on the 5th of August downgraded AAA into AA+, it denotes America's inability. If it is our 3 A's, it is extremely strong capacity to meet obligations. Extremely strong capacity to meet all the obligations. But extreme goes away, then it becomes AA+. There are 19 countries still with AAA rating, but the GDP of all those 19 countries put together is just 80% of the US GDP of $14.5 trillion. Now, why America has come to this state? Profligate America. Since 1976, it has been incurring current account deficits, and these have accumulated to nearly about $10 trillion. The accumulation of the current account deficit is so much, and two-thirds of it, because deficit means it is giving IOUs, promissory notes, to the rest of the world, and to back it up, it is simply printing notes and notes. It has become the most wonderful, profitable business of the United States of America. Alan Greenspan once said, "You Asians, why are you saving so much money? If America is there not to borrow and to consume, then what will you do with your money?" That's what Alan Greenspan said in his great arrogance. Friends, in the 1980s, the interest rate of the Federal Reserve was 20%. In 1990s, it was 9%. In the year 2000, it was 1%. By reducing this rate of interest, it encouraged profligate spending by the United States and citizens. Every citizen of the United States is indebted to the extent of 1.5 years of his earning. They have got credit cards, but not cash. So it is this profligacy of the United States of America. We consume and consume. The world's excess production is all consumed by the United States of America, and it is paying us in printed dollars. For how long can it go? One of the reasons for India is doing the same thing now. Even before creating wealth, in order to have the vote, populism is resorted to. For example, one of our chief ministers said, "I'll make 1 crore of women in Andhra Pradesh Lakapatis." 1,00,000 crores of rupees has been given. The government says, I will give, take loans, take loans, take loans. And the party, political party say, don't pay back, don't pay back. This is what is happening. 7,500 crores of rupees have been promised by the current chief minister for NREGA, the engineering like this. 3,600 crores of rupees as fee reimbursement for good for nothing, useless engineering students. Now 75% of the people of India are to be given food scarcity, which will cost us 1,00,000 crores of rupees every year. Can we afford this? This is what America has been doing. But America, people had some faith in the American dollar. Only now it is shaken. If India also goes on a spending spree, that is, before we have created the capacity to meet the obligations, and if we go on giving loans and spending the money, the lesson is what is likely to happen to the United States of America will happen to India. It was so profligate in the decade, in the years 2005 to 2008, it was giving what was called ninja loans. Government companies, banks were giving ninja loans because the president said everybody must have a house. So everybody, what it is all, ninja means no income, no job, no asset. So for everybody the loans were denied. And all these were collateralized debt obligations. New things were invented. Derivatives were invented. They were called WMDs, that is, weapons of mass destruction. Mathematicians produced pages and pages of equations, derivative by derivative by derivative, collateralized and go on sending. The lesson is that if you spend more than what you create, what the wealth that you create, bankruptcy is certain to come. The only wise countries are China and India. Although they are the globalization process, we have got enough intelligent people and the regulatory mechanisms that they are trying to prevent the catastrophe that has overtaken the United States of America. So friends, willingly we have been drawn into globalization because we have always said Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the whole world is one family. We have also said, Ano Bhadra Hartavo Nantu Vishwataha, let noble thoughts come from all over the world. But most ignoble thoughts that have been tried and discarded are leading to this catastrophe in the United States of America are what are being embraced by some of the Indian politicians. That is one of the lessons we have to learn. We must create wealth first. We must see that inequalities are reduced. That must be public policy. But throwing away money before it is created, that is what the United States of America, we have faith, the world is no longer having faith. So we have got two experts who have helped us, enlightening us on the death crisis. The lessons to be learned are, a nation cannot be, these are the words of the S. Gurumurthy, there is a beautiful article in the Indian Express a few weeks ago. A nation cannot be more prosperous than its people. If people are indicted as the government of Andhra Pradesh and the government, the UPA government is saying, take loans to address your place. Prosperous than, it cannot be more prosperous than its people. It cannot be more solvent than its people. In the United States, the home debt is 1.5 years of whatever their income is there, that much is the debt. It cannot be more liquid than its people. People need to have cash in their hands, not credit cards. Dhanyavad.